DaVinci Resolve 16.1 has been out for a few weeks now, and it is just packed with some awesome features. One of them in specific, we have all been waiting for in the DaVinci Resolve community. It's true full screen. You don't have to buy a card that's 200 bucks from Blackmagic just to use the full screen feature. Now in DaVinci Resolve 16.1, they have built in the full screen feature, and trust me when I say it, you're gonna love it. Now, for those of you who are like me who switched from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve, this has like been the one feature that we've all missed. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to enable and tell you a few things, a few quirks, a few pro tips that you should know when you're using this feature. But let's get into the video. First, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest videos put out and to stay part of the conversation. So now that we're in DaVinci Resolve, it's super straightforward from here. All we do is we go into workspace, scroll on down to full screen viewer, put it to whatever display you want, and you need more than one display hooked up to your computer. If you don't, it really, you just won't be able to really do anything. Actually, the screen won't show up. So for me, it's display one, and nothing happened. So if I move this out of the way though, it pops up. And now we have the full screen. So you can't assign full screen to the same window that you're editing on. Don't leave yet, I have some stuff to tell you. DaVinci Resolve 16.1's in beta, it's not finished. So there are some fun, annoying glitches that come along with it. One of them being with the full screen. On multiple occasions, I've had it where there was like just two full screens on my monitors and I had like no timeline. So of course, you know, you have to save everything and then you just exit out, but it's tedious. And also I've had it where there was like the program freezes, but it doesn't, like you can't click on anything, but it doesn't crash. It's kind of annoying and you just need to like restart the whole program. So there are some random glitches that they haven't gotten out yet because it's a beta. If you're like me and you've come from Premiere Pro and for a while you put up with the crashes and the freezes and the unreliability and the stability issues, this will be a cakewalk for you. But I'm just letting you know, fair warning, I do not want anybody blaming me for leading you in the wrong direction. There's some glitches with it. So there it is. That is how you enable the full screen viewer on DaVinci Resolve 16.1. In the comments below, let me know if you think it's worth it to upgrade to this beta version, which is a little more unreliable and not stable, just for this feature. As usual, the video on the top is four tips in DaVinci Resolve 16 for better slow motion. Check it out, it's awesome. And the video on the bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. Anyway, until the next one, peace.